Hello students, welcome back. In this video lecture, we will be discussing the question number 175 of NEET 2018 question paper. The question reads, in which disease does mosquito-transmitted pathogen cause chronic inflammation of lymphatic vessels? And the options given are ringworm disease, ascariasis, elephantiasis and amebiasis. Before discussing this question, I'd like to discuss some topics with you. What is a disease? Disease is something unusual happening in our body. Right? Disease is something unusual happening in our body. Disease is caused due to a pathogen or microorganisms. Right? And these pathogens can be anything. That can be a bacteria, that can be a virus, that can be a fungus, etc. Right? It can be a protozoan, right? And the animal or the source or the carrier which carries these microorganisms, and they cause the disease in human beings. They are known as vectors, right? What is the function of vector? What do vectors do? Vectors just carry the bacteria or the virus, right? And when they bite, for suppose in this example, the vector we are talking about is mosquito, right? For suppose in the blood of mosquito, there is a virus, right? So what happens when the mosquito bites a human being? Then the human being gets infected with this virus, right? Because the virus present in the blood of the mosquito gets into human being, right? Gets into the blood of human being. That does not mean that the mosquito is actually causing the disease, right? Mosquito is a carrier, right? The disease is caused by the virus and not the mosquito, right? But it is the causing disease. It is the source through which the causing agent reaches the human being, right? Hope you get the point. Now, let's discuss about these four diseases, okay? Now, before that, let's discuss about the lymphatic vessels. What do you mean by lymphatic vessels and lymphatic system? You all know the importance of blood type or blood system, right? Blood system, blood vessels. But what is this lymphatic system then? This is a parallel circulatory system that runs to the blood system, right? But what is the function? The main important function is to remove excess fluid from different tissues. So what it does, it removes the excess fluid from different tissues. Right, now let's discuss the first option given, that is the ringworm disease. Now, the ringworm disease is caused due to a fungus. Okay, so it is basically a fungal infection. Right, it is due to a fungus. But how does the, you know, fungus travels? The fungus, it is, the infection occurs because of human to human contact, right? What do you mean by that? It is a contagious disease, right? It is a communicable disease that spreads due to human contact, but not due to the mosquito biting, right? It does not spread due to mosquito bite. So, first option cannot be the answer, right? Let's discuss about the second option, that is ascariasis. The ascariasis is caused due to a roundworm, right? It is caused due to a roundworm called ascariasis, right? That is why the name is also ascariasis. The name of the disease is also ascariasis. Now, how does this disease occur? This occurs due to, this disease spreads due to the intake of contaminated food and water, right? Contaminated food and water, right? So, it does not occur due to mosquito bite. So second option cannot be the answer. Let's discuss the third option, elephantiasis. Now, why the name elephantiasis? Do you know the other name of elephantiasis is lymphatic filariasis? Right, lymphatic filariasis. By the name, you can now guess that the answer is option 3, that is elephantiasis. Now, why the name elephantiasis? Because, see, this is also caused due to a roundworm. Okay, but what was the difference? See, ascariasis was also caused due to a roundworm, right? But it was not the correct option because it was spread due to consumption of contaminated food and water and not due to the mosquito bite, right? But in elephantiasis, it generally transmits through the biting of a mosquito, through the mosquito. So here, mosquito is a vector, right? So what happens when this elephantiasis occurs? What happens? This infects our lymphatic system, right? Lymphatic vessels. So what happens when it infects the lymphatic system? Our lymphatic system gets swollen up, and due to that, it will not be able to remove the excess fluid from different tissues. So it will result in swelling up of legs and arms, right? So what happens? Our legs occur like a leg of an elephant, right? It is so huge. Why? Because the excess fluid which was getting removed because of the lymphatic system is not done, right? That is why it is known as elephantiasis. So our third option is the correct option. And when we talk about the fourth option, that is amoebiasis. Amoebiasis is caused due to a protozoan, and the spread occurs due to the consumption of contaminated food and water. Right? So our clear cut option is option number 3, that is elephantiasis. Thank you.